Okay, my name is Haren Vakil. I'm an architect by training, and in the last 15 years I've started, you know, painting seriously, and mainly my work is rooted in, you know, surreal or fantastic, and my mainly paintings are very whimsical. They are pretty, I don't have any real theme or subject matter. I just start something and wherever it takes me, that's what happens. And the painting is kind of pretty irrational and absurd in many ways. What else can I say about it is I draw a lot too, in the sense with pen and ink and on the side, because painting takes a long time, so I draw on the side to finish, you know, to produce some kind of product, and those drawings sometimes come into the painting. But that's another thing I do, because I love doodling, and I've been doodling all my life, right from the young age, and that comes out in my painting. And I like surreal art. Being born in India, my affinity to surrealism is quite natural. And people like Magritte, Dali, Hieronymus Bosch, and many, many others, you know, they all influence me, including the primitive art. And I don't have any theme for my work, in the sense they are all individual pieces of work. And besides that, I don't know much to say about them, because my paintings are not cerebral. I don't think about them much, except I have great fun making them, and that's what I do.
Hello, my name is Joe Coffey, and we're here at my feature of new works today, and I'm just going to talk a bit about my work. And as you can see, there's a lot of animals and figurative work as well. I tend to work in figurative work with animals and people. I often get asked why I started with animals, and probably 8 years ago, I moved to Pender Island, and I'd grown up on a farm, and just getting reacquainted with the animal imagery, it spoke to me, and something just clicked, and I had a real, just a natural empathy for that subject matter. And it worked, and it kind of went from there. So that's why I often have animals as my artwork. But recently, I have been starting to explore human figurative work, as well as just other creatures in the natural world, and plants as well, of course, including this buttercup. And I have the moth over there. It's kind of actually rejuvenated my muse trying a different subject. I have to say that. It's been a lot of fun. And I've had a lot of fun working with the different images. And I think, just like art in general, who knows where it's going to take me and which directions I'll go. But right now it seems to be kind of a mixed bag of both animals and figurative work. We actually have some human figurative work over here, including some pieces from my last solo show last year, and a funky self-portrait I did with my toucan. So as you can see, I am starting to explore the human figure. And it's interesting actually how what I bring to the process when painting the human figure is slightly different than when painting the animals. And this is something I kind of noted in myself when I'm working. So, yeah. So this is it. And I hope you enjoy.
Fleming's show right now is filled with so many memories, because when I walked in the door, the first thing I saw was this piece that was in the opening show of my gallery in 1984, and I have pictures of it in the installation, so it's beautiful to see. And then also it's just, well, I guess it's a walk through memory lane a bit, because paintings in the front of the gallery, paintings that, you know, that I've seen from this place, and as they've done a retrospective, they've been doing a survey. So I think it's a great show to sort of show many sides of it.